In Isaiah chapter 22, the Most High gives us a prophecy that is for the burden of the valley of vision. This prophecy begins with speaking of those of you that have been slain by the judgment at Yahweh's word, that are not actually dead yet, and are still dwelling in your houses, rejoicing in your walking dead state of being. It speaks of all of your leaders and all of you that are found with them being thrust abroad together and bound from the bow, far away from the physical land of the promise. Bound from the bow is referring to you being bound from the bow of Yahweh's covenant that he cut with his servant Noah and sent to live far away in the captivity of the lies that he gave you over to believe into. This is just a reality that you are soon going to be shown is true. He honored your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts, and he thrust those of you that are the scattered descendants of Israel into these faraway lands. It is what it is. And now he is going to gather the remnant of those of you that will turn back to him so that your children can live into this new era of time. The Valley of Vision is referring to the valley that is below his holy mountain, where he has reared up his altar in the midst of your captivity, per his Isaiah chapter 19 and his Ezekiel chapter 43 prophecies. In verse 9 of this Valley of Vision prophecy, he tells us the following. And see the cracks of the city of David, because they are multiplied, and be gathered to the waters of the lower pool. He caused this lower pool to be dug below the courtyards of his house a year and almost 3 months ago, on the 18th day of the 8th month. This is the same day that he caused Maher Shalal Kuspaz to first be conceived in the womb this year. 3 months from this waypoint is the 18th day of the 11th month. This is the day that the Almighty Elohim caused his servant Noah to let loose the second dove that brought back the olive branch. Yahweh caused his only begotten son to use this lower pool as part of the vehicle that he used in the healing of the man that had been blind from birth. The Greek word that is used in his record of this event in John chapter 9, verses 7 and 11, is siloam. Siloam means to depart or to send away. The origin of this word is the Hebrew word siloak. This word means the same, to depart or to send away. Yahweh speaks of this pool by name in Nehemiah chapter 3, verse 15, and in his Maher Shalal Kuspaz prophecy in Isaiah chapter 8, verse 6. In light of all of these details, what are the odds that this pool was dug exactly 1 year prior to Maher's first conception on the 18th day of the 8th month? I say first conception because Yahweh removed him from the womb and he put him back into his Isaiah chapter 8 prophetess's womb as part of his warning cry that he has sent me with. This lower pool is spoken about three times in what is called the Old Testament and a fourth time in John chapter 9. This is yet another parallel to his three of this and that, and a fourth. When Yeshua put the clay that he mixed with his spit upon the man that was born from both's dual eyes, he told him to go and wash in this pool, and this man departed from this pool seeing. We can know that this pool is the lower pool of this Isaiah chapter 22 prophecy because the pool of Siloam was located in the southeastern part of Jerusalem nearly 2,000 years ago when this event took place, and his word tells us that this pool was going to be located south and east of the courtyards of his house at this time as well. And also, this pool is the lower pool of the dual pools that he has caused to be dug here at his house at this time. In chapter 4, verse 2 of his My Messenger, or his Malachi prophecy, he tells us that he has sent his Son of Righteousness with healing upon my wings. The event with the man that was born blind was a foreshadow of those of you that will turn back to the Most High at this time, coming to his pool of departure and being sent away from these waters with dual eyes to see him and dual ears to hear him. He will do so through his renewing of his covenant per his Jeremiah chapter 31 prophecy when you do so. The new thing of this Jeremiah chapter 31 prophecy is his bringing forth Maher from the king's daughter's womb per his Psalms 45 prophecy and his Isaiah chapter 8 prophecy. Nehemiah chapter 3 verse 15 tells us that this lower pool was by the king's garden and that it was unto the steps that go down from the city of David. This was a prophecy that is for the here and the now, just like the rest of the roll of his word was given to us upon his second anointed son and upon this place that he has chosen for his name to dwell here. This lower pool was dug between the 8 steps that go down from Kikwe's courtyards and the king's garden. These 8 steps go down from his courtyards on the southeastern corner of them. According to Nehemiah chapter 3, verse 15, his courtyards represent the city of David at this time. I said that Kikwe also speaks of this pool in his Meher Shalah Kusmaz prophecy. When he does so, he tells us that you are going to despise the waters of departure that journey softly. This is what you have done in despising the manner that he is bringing forth Meher and not coming to this place to be healed. The previous verse of this Isaiah chapter 22 prophecy tells us that he was going to reveal the covering of Judah at this time. He has done so. He has revealed that which will cause him to be your covering. However, he has not yet revealed the covering of his holy mountain on a physical plane as of yet. This is going to change. When he told us this about revealing the covering of Judah, he tells us to consider the armory of his house that he has reared up in a forest at this time. The armory of his house is located in a forest that surrounds the courtyards of his house. He refers to his house as an armory because it is located inside of the 144 cubit tall wall that surrounds this parcel of soil. He calls this parcel of ground the parcel that he has risen up for the decreeing of his righteous judgments. And see the cracks of the city of David is referring to the dry and parched soil that Kikwe has reared up his house upon that has been cracking as a result of no rain here since the time that Meher was first conceived until last night. He has not yet sent the physical waters forth from this place, however he has sent forth his living waters. In a broader sense, it also is referring to Jerusalem, which surrounded the city of David. Many of his end time prophecies that are for Jerusalem are referring to the chief seat of the scattered descendants of Israel at this time, which is the United States. This is a land that is in a famine of listening to his word, just like the rest of the scattered descendants of Israel exist in this condition. You are in a decayed state of existence. There are many details in the testimony of his word that testify to this reality, including the fact that he has reared up his Isaiah chapter 19 and his Ezekiel chapter 43 altar in this land. The valley that is below his house is a large valley that is located to the south and to the east of this parcel of cracking soil. Last night's rain was just some short sprinkles, and the cracks remain upon the courtyards of his house. I look upon this rain as a harbinger that things are beginning to change. I look at it as a harbinger that he is getting ready to pour down the rain of his hot indignation upon those of you that are going to find yourselves in the outer darkness. I did not write down when it last rained here during the month that Meher was first conceived. However, there is a prophecy that I will discuss in a bit that makes me think that it was exactly 3 months prior to last night's showers. Verse 1 of this Isaiah chapter 22 prophecy tells us that he is speaking to those of you that have gone up to your housetops. Therefore, this is a prophecy that is for those of you that have remained in your houses after the abomination of desolation has been revealed to you. Yeshua prophesied of this when he told us to not go up to our housetops when the abomination of desolation is revealed. I said that the beginning of this prophecy tells us that you are dead. However, that you are not yet dead on a physical plane. Verse 2 tells us that you are not yet dead by the sword and by the war that are soon going to be sent upon you. Instead, you are the walking dead before the Most High's faces. Up until now, Kikwe has only slain you with the judgment of his war. However, this is getting ready to change as well. He is going to send the physical sword upon those of you that continue to live in rebellion to him. Verse 2 also tells us that there is a shouting and a noise in your midst. The noise is referring to the cry that the Most High has sent me with, including the 13 laps of the 7-day march around the courtyards of his house that he orchestrated at the beginning of the second month of this year. These details combine together to tell us that verse 9 is telling you to look upon the place that does not yet have the physical water flowing out from it, and look upon that which has resulted from 3 months of no rain at this place, the cracks that have resulted, and see your decayed state of being and be gathered to his pool of departure in order to be healed ahead of him sending forth these waters on a physical plane. But now that the winter has begun on a particular Sabbath day that followed the one smooth stone that he has caused me to hurl at your uncircumcised hearts, the dual doors of his house have been closed, and the getting to this place that he has chosen for his name to dwell here is going to be a very difficult journey, one that I highly suggest that you do not murmur against him on. Verse 4 tells you to weep grievously because of your state of being. His telling us this ties in with his Psalms 84 prophecy, where he tells us that some of you are going to pass over the valley of weeping, referring to the valley of this Isaiah chapter 22 vision prophecy, and go to the fountain that he's put in place, the fountain of his living waters. Isaiah chapter 22 verse 5 tells us that this vision is for the day of trouble, which is going to break down your high and lofty walls. He held back doing so at the time of the 7-day march around his house that was in the second month, when I thought that he was going to do so, and even since then. However, as of 3 days journey from yesterday's Sabbath, we will be in another 7-day period of time that is discussed in the last video that will end on the third dove waypoint. I do not know for sure when he is going to do so. However, I do know that the day when he is going to do so is at hand. And I know that once again he has given us much evidence that points to the seventh day. This seventh day follows the 6 days that are from the second dove that take us to the 24th day of the 11th month. The 24th day of the 11th month is the day that he ascribes to the first 6 chapters of his Zechariah prophecy that is for his measuring rod going forth and his building his house in your midst at this time. The next verse certainly tells us that he is going to do so in association with this lower pool gathering prophecy. Verse 10, and count the houses of Jerusalem, the houses that are going to be broken down that are fenced with the wall. His instruction for you to count the houses that are going to be broken down is telling you to consider that you remain on your housetops, and in doing so you are being numbered with the houses that are going to come crashing down. Consider that you have not been numbered by him at his house. You have not been numbered by him as his people because you have not been seen to him at the place that he has chosen for his name to dwell here, like he has commanded you to do. He goes on, a ditch has been made between dual walls for the waters of the lower of the old pool, but you have not had regard to your maker, and you have not been seen of him that fashioned it long ago. The lower pool that is located below the courtyards of his house is going to be filled by a ditch that is in place, that is built up in the manner of dual walls. This pool of departure is going to be filled with waters that are going to flow out from his upper pool. The upper wall of this ditch forms the eastern border of his courtyards, and the lower wall of it is in place to funnel the waters that will pour out from his upper pool into his lower pool in order to fill it when he sends forth these physical waters. I did not even know about this prophecy when he caused these dual walls to be built up. This verse tells us that he purposed these dual walls and these dual pools to be established a long, long time ago. He did so even before he put Adam and Eve in his garden of delight. In Amos chapter 4, verse 7, he tells us that he is going to withhold rain from one city for 3 months in a continuance that is associated with the harvest, and that he is going to send rain upon another one city. This verse tells us that these dual cities are parcels of ground. It tells us that the parcel of ground of the one city that he has withheld rain from these three months dried up. Is it a coincidence that this parcel of ground that his word tells us is symbolic of the city of David has the cracks that it does, and it has not rained here for 3 months? The next verse tells us that two or three cities wandered as fugitives wander to one city to drink waters, but were not satisfied, and that you still refuse to turn back to Yahweh. This is symbolic of you remaining in the captivity, even though these 3 months of continued warnings from your Maker have been sent to you. Meher's first conception followed Yahweh's fall harvest feast of ingathering that he extended to 14 days this year. If I were you, I would seriously consider the cracks that remain upon the city of David at this time so that you do not die. The first time that the Hebrew word for Zion is used is in 2 Samuel 5, verse 9, where we are told that Zion is the same as the city of David. Zion means a stone marker that is set up in a dry and parched land. His Jeremiah chapter 31 renewing of his covenant prophecy tells us that he was going to set up Zions to mark his highway out from the captivity at this time. These Zions are the 46 whitewashed stones that make up the boulder design of his house. He has made this so simple. He has made this a simple matter of believing the roll of his book that is written upon the one that is speaking his word to you. His word says so. Believe his word, or else prepare to die in rebellion to it.